To do this, I first want to look at the structure of credit card and see what I'm given already. I'm implementing a method, isValid, which returns a Boolean. isValid calculates whether the credit card has a valid number, and returns true if the number is valid and false if it's not. So now I know how to write my test program. I need to create two credit cards. I'll create a valid card, and I have to mark that this is a long by writing the L at the end. And I switched two digits to get the invalid card. Now I print out the actual value of isValid when called on the valid card, and I expect the valid card to be valid. The actual for the invalid card should be false. Now it'll be easy to test whether our implementation works. In the credit card class, we can see that the first part of the pseudocode, setting sum to zero and count to zero, is the same as the code that we had before for computing the sum of digits. So I'll keep that the same. The for each digit, starting from the right part, is the same. So I'll try to keep the code for counting the iterations in place. But now instead of just adding the digit to the sum, I need to check whether the count is even or odd, and how big the digit is, and use that to decide what to do with the sum. So if the count mod 2 is 1, we add the digit to the sum. Else, if the digit is less than 5, we add twice the digit to the sum. Otherwise, we add twice the digit to the sum and subtract 9. And now, instead of just printing the sum the way we did before, we need to check whether the card number is valid. If the last digit of the sum is 0, the card number is valid. Sum mod 10 equals 0 is true when the last digit of sum is 0, and false otherwise. So we return that. For example, if the sum were 24, we would check. Sum mod 10 would be 4, which is not 0, so returning this result would return false. If sum were 20, then we would check. Sum mod 10 is 0, so this would be true, so we would return true. But we can't be sure that this works until we test it. Let's compile and run the tester. Huh. One of our tests failed. It's saying that the invalid card is valid. We're going to need more information if we want to debug this. What if I print each digit of the number? So if we run the credit card tester, that's funny, it printed exactly the same thing. My print line statement must not have run. For this statement not to run, we would have to never go into the loop. What's n? If I run it again, I find that n is this weird negative number. That looks a little bit like the result of an integer overflow. Clearly, n can't be an int anymore. Now if I try to compile, I get a possible loss of precision. So if I want an int digit, I'm going to have to cast this somehow. What if I try casting n mod 10 this way? Looks like I didn't remove the cast that was causing trouble. Now it looks like it's starting with the correct n, and then taking off one digit at a time correctly. But it's still getting the wrong answer for the valid card. I'll delete this now that I have that part working. And I think I actually want to print out the digit itself rather than n. And then I want to get some idea of what I do with each digit. So I'll print the digit, and then on the same line, I'll print add it to the sum, add twice the digit to the sum, or add twice the digit and subtract 9. Now if I run the tester again, I should get much better information. It looks like the first digit is minus 9, but none of the digits should be negative. It looks like this cast didn't work properly. Maybe it's casting n before it takes the mod 10, instead of casting the result of the n mod 10. Let's see if these parentheses fix it. Now if I run the main method again, I can see I'm still not getting what I expected. But I have some good data here. For 3, I add twice the digit to the sum, 1 I add twice the digit to the sum, and so on. Let's compare that with the example on the web page. In the example, the 3 shouldn't get doubled. The 1 should, though. The next 1 shouldn't. The 9 should. In fact, it looks like we're adding twice the digit way too often here. It seems like count mod 2 never equals 1. So let's check what count is. With system out print line count plus count. Now the main method says count is always 0. I know how to fix that. I'll increment count. Now for the valid card, I'm getting true when I expected true. And for the invalid card, I'm getting false when I expected false. I have just a tiny bit of cleanup left to do. to remove all of these extra system out print lines that I added. I removed all of the print statements in the credit card class, and now when I run the test, the output is much cleaner.